Many quantum algorithms utilize the concept of phase, which is often misunderstood. Thus, this video is an attempt to clarify this concept. The video is structured as follows. First, I will explain phase shifts in wave functions. Next, I will build on that to discuss the quantum concept of global phase. Following that, I will provide proof that global phase does not affect the measurement of our quantum state. Then, I will introduce the concept of relative phase. Finally, I will show that two quantum states that differ only by a relative phase can still be distinguishable when measured. Let's start. Phase shift in wave functions. Consider the graph of sine function. Although any wave function could serve our purpose, the sine function is widely recognized and works well for our illustration. The process of moving this graph horizontally to the left or right is known as phase shift. In this example diagram, the graph has shifted by pi over 2 radians or 90 degrees, resulting in a phase shift of pi over 2. Since points on a wave function can be represented on the unit circle, a phase shift can also be thought of as moving those points counterclockwise or clockwise on the unit circle. Now let's discuss global phase shift in quantum states. Typically, books and discussion in quantum computing do not use the term shift, which can be confusing. Think of global or relative phase in quantum computing as analogous to phase shift in wave functions we covered earlier. Consider a quantum state or an n-qubit register. If we multiply this entire register by Euler number raised to the power I theta, this is termed as a global phase shift of theta radians. For example, suppose we have a quantum register ket psi equals to 1 over square root of 2 ket 0 plus 1 over square root of 2 ket 1. Multiplying this entire register by Euler number raised to the power I pi over 2 results in a global phase shift of pi over 2. Each point on the unit circle can be represented by Euler number raised to the power I theta. When theta is 0, we are at 1. At theta equals to pi over 2 radians, that is 90 degrees, we have I. At theta equals pi radians, that is 180 degrees, we have minus 1. And finally, when theta is 3 pi over 2 radians, that is 270 degrees, we have minus I. Therefore, multiplying the above quantum state by Euler number raised to the power I times pi over 2 is the same as simply multiplying it by I. Similarly, when we multiply the quantum state by minus 1, then we give it a phase shift of pi radians. Now, here is an important concept to remember. When it comes to measurement, we can never distinguish between two quantum registers that are in the same state but differ only in their global phase. The global phase does not affect the measurement outcome of our quantum state. Let's quickly prove it. Given an n qubit register ket psi and any orthonormal basis beta 1, beta 2, dot 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 beta n, the probability of outcome beta I, where I ranges from 1 to n, is equals to ket psi conjugate transpose times m beta I times ket psi. This is equivalent to bra psi times m beta I times ket psi, where m beta I is known as the projection operator and is equal to ket beta I times bra beta I. In case you want to know more about projection operator, I will provide a link to a related video in the description for you. Now, let's attach a global phase to ket psi by multiplying it with Euler number raised to the power I theta. We use the same method of projection operator to measure it for the same basis. Our probability of measuring beta I in this case will be the conjugate transpose of Euler number raised to the power I theta ket psi times m beta I times Euler number raised to the power I theta ket psi. This will be equals to bra psi times Euler number raised to the power of minus I theta times m beta I times Euler number raised to the power I theta ket psi. We can take out Euler number raised to the power minus I theta and Euler number raised to the power I theta. They will cancel each other out. The resultant measurement result will be the same as it was for ket psi prior to the global phase shift. This proves that global phase does not change the measurement outcome of a quantum state. Now, let's describe the concept of relative phase. In relative phase, each component of a quantum state may have a different phase shift. For example, consider a quantum register ket psi equals to 1 over square root of 2 times ket 0 plus 1 over square root of 2 times ket 1. Now, consider another quantum register ket phi equals to 1 over square root of 2 times ket 0 minus 1 over square root of 2 times ket 1. Note that in both registers, ket 0 has the same amplitude. In contrast, ket 1 has the same magnitude since square of 1 over square root of 2 and square of minus 1 over square root of 2 are the same. However, they both have different phases. If we choose the right basis, we can distinguish these states. For instance, in the basis of ket 0 and ket 1, both registers measure the same. However, in the basis of cat plus and cat minus, these resistors are distinguishable. If you have any doubts about how to measure these resistors in different bases, then please watch my videos about measuring qubits and post your questions in the comments. That is it for this video. If you like this video, please consider supporting this channel. Your support means a lot to me. Hope to see you around. Bye.